Hi, my name is Evan Ruderman, and I'm representing the Carroll Creek Rotary Club. Several years ago, as is tradition in the Ruderman household, my mom asked where I would like to go for my 15th birthday. The possibilities were endless. We could go biking, spend the day at the beach, go to Six Flags, anything that struck my fancy. I sat and thought about it for a while before returning with my decision. No bikes, no beaches, and no roller coasters. I wanted to visit NASA. Why, you might ask? Well, you could take one look at my bedroom and have your answer. Across my ceiling lived scatterings of glow-in-the-dark stars, pasted up there years ago. There was a rocket ship, crafted from tinfoil and cardboard, hanging with the twinkling lights alongside plastic models of every planet in the solar system. So, that was what we did, leaving for Greenbelt, Maryland, early one July morning to avoid the morning rush hour. Now, the visitor center at Goddard may be relatively small, but it is filled to the brim with every sort of satellite, capsule, and display imaginable. To top it off, there's an entire garden in the back, teeming with dozens of varieties of rockets. Naturally, I was bursting with enthusiasm. Come on, Mom, let's go check out the Sputnik replica again. Do you want to look at the rocket garden some more? And look over there, there's a real Gemini capsule you can sit in. Apparently, my excited voice must have carried. A man approached us not long into our visit, whose name tag indicated that he worked at the visitor center. In my eyes, he might as well have been Neil Armstrong. His own passion for space exploration was soon revealed as he offered to personally give us a tour of the center. We must have talked for nearly an hour on everything space, ranging from the Hubble Space Telescope to the planets of the solar system. Throughout, he gave me posters, pamphlets, and books, and by the time I left, I had a stack nearly as tall as I was. And believe me, afterwards, I read every single one. The first question of the Rotary Club four-way test asks, is it the truth? Leaving NASA's visitor center with the biggest smile possible, I knew that pursuing a future in space and science was my truth. It's a genuine passion that still sparks a fire in me today. And it's not just me. I know that in every single one of NASA's facilities across the country and the globe, there are people just like the man that I met who dedicate their time and energy to showing the next generation how brilliant and fascinating science can be. Just as important is the second question of the test, which asks if it is fair to all concerned. In this case, I believe that we are all concerned in the exploration of our galaxy, and NASA provides those opportunities to all people, whether they're working in the field or simply enthusiasts for all things space. For example, NASA TV allows everybody to watch rockets launch live as if they are actually there, and educational centers like the one in Greenbelt are targeted towards every single visitor, whether they're 15 or 50. We must also ask if it is beneficial to all concerned. The answer to this question is tangible, life-improving innovations spurred by space exploration. Technologies benefiting all of mankind have been developed in the laboratories and testing grounds of NASA missions. Cochlear implants were developed so that those born deaf could be given the opportunity to hear. Satellites were designed so that countries in the Caribbean and around the globe could prepare for hurricanes in real time as they form. Water purification systems have allowed for safe and reliable drinking water sources for developing countries. All of these technologies and developments are possible because of NASA. The benefits are literally right in your pocket. Investigations into computer systems for the moon missions propelled forward electronics. Today, those same electronics allow us to call somebody across the globe and speak to them in an instant on a cell phone. This leaves us with one final question, and one that I find immensely important. Will it build goodwill and better friendships? 2 weeks after my glorious day at NASA, I received a package in the mail. It's addressed from Goddard, and inside is something that I still consider my favorite type of gift, a book. That man, who spoke to me for so long, who saw that passion for space and science inside of me, he remembered our conversation. He remembered, in particular, our discussion of one man, Dr. John Mather, a Nobel Prize laureate who works at Goddard and developed a satellite with his team that helped us learn more about the history of our universe. This man, who I can now comfortably call a friend, had tracked down Dr. Mather and requested him to inscribe a note to me, personally, on the inside of this book, his book. I have it right here. The note is simple, to Evan, with best wishes, but the length that my new friend went to stoke that fire of enthusiasm inside of me paid off. We still exchange letters today. This is how friendships are formed and how people are united, together, with a common goal in mind. For NASA, and for me, that goal is to explore those regions of the universe we do not yet know, and to never stop seeking answers. Because sometimes they're more beautiful than we can imagine. In Moby Dick, Herman Melville wrote, I am tormented with an everlasting itch for things remote. I love to sail forbidden seas and land on barbarous coasts. I too share this itch, this passion, this urge to go. It was cultivated by a program that not only propels us into the future of discovery, but invites people my age to join in on the adventure. NASA helps create a future that we all want to participate in. And that is something that is truthful, fair, beneficial, and uniting, through and through. Thank you.